Hello, Krista.
Hello, Ilmar.
Now we are here in the University of Tartu library lobby, and behind us is a smart locker for book lending, which played an important role during COVID-19 first wave.
In fact, this locker is just one good example. So in our following presentation, we will talk you a little bit more about different kind of initiatives that were taken in Estonian libraries during the COVID-19 first wave.
So now we are back in our institute, and I will tell you a little bit more about the Estonian libraries and librarians during the COVID-19 outbreak. Actually, this presentation was made by two authors, Ilmar Vaaro and myself, but at the moment I will give the presentation myself. We are both working at the University of Tartu Institute of Social Sciences in Estonia. And to start this presentation, our starting point actually comes from the postdoctoral project called the Workplace of Memory Institutions Professionals in the Context of Acceleration of Social Time. But however, in the late evening of March 12th this year, everything changed because the emergency situation due to COVID-19 outbreak was declared in Estonia. And already in advance, we can say that it was ending on May 15th. So this emergency situation changed the course of this project a little bit. So we asked ourselves and our research participants as well, what are the main activities in Estonian libraries as institutions during the COVID-19 outbreak? And we also started to ask the question about the librarians as professionals and individuals, how they cope with issues related to workplace during the COVID-19 outbreak. So for the context of our study, we started to monitor the situation of all libraries which are open for the public. In Estonia, we have 545 libraries. And these 545 libraries include all public libraries, all scientific libraries, the National Library of Estonia, and the Estonian Children's Literature Center. And we aim to collect as much information, as comprehensive information as possible by collecting it from public online resources. So for the quantitative analysis about different kind of activities conducted in Estonian libraries, we visited the public Facebook pages, which were actually the main source of information during the emergency situation. We also visited library homepages and local municipalities' homepages. And we found out that the changes during the emergency situation are reflected mostly on Facebook. So this is the most operative information channel. And by the end of our study, we collected 100% coverage of information about Estonian libraries. And what we collected the main information available for readers. Is the library open or not? What kind of services are still provided? How to contact the librarian? And what to do when one has the overdue renewal? So what kind of activities the libraries still conducted during the COVID-19 outbreak emergency situation? The libraries actually still continued with different kind of activities like acquisition, cataloging, preservation, and withdrawal. Some libraries, when the visitors could not enter the library buildings anymore, they started their inventories, they started to compile databases and local bibliographies. Plus, some also started big spring cleaning or some small renovation works. Then, of course, in many libraries which were closed, the libraries and librarians, they did their best to provide contact-free lending. So during the first week of the emergency situation, there were just 45% of Estonian libraries open. And later, as you can see from the slide, the number of libraries was gradually increasing. So by the end of the emergency situation in Estonia, there were 95 libraries, 95% of libraries which were open. And throughout the emergency situation, there were actually 45% of libraries which were open. And librarians were very inventive. They left books carefully packed, of course, behind the door in the corridors, also handed them over the wind from the window to the visitors. It was also, in some places, they also provided home delivery, and some libraries also provided access to e-books. And the parcel lockers, just like the one you saw in our starting clip, were also very used in some few bigger libraries. And in some cases, of course, these parcel lockers located within or close to the library, and sometimes also the postal services lockers were used. Besides technical services, the libraries also did their best to accommodate the needs of their visitors. So social media was really important during the emergency situation. And in Estonia, of course, the Facebook is very much used, very widely used. We could detect that the total number of posts from January to May this year was over 10,000 posts. And we could also see that the frequency of posting changed when the average number of posts in January, February was one post per 3 days, when in April, libraries posted even one post in 2 days. And in April, the number of posts increased more than 50% in comparison to January and February. But in May, the number of posts was at the same level as in January and February, so that things started to normalize a little bit. And during the emergency situation, we could also see that the library started to provide more content about national events than previously. Previously, they mostly provided information about events which were like local events in their own libraries or in their own county. And of course, in the second phase of this study, we will conduct some more research about the content of Facebook posts, but this is something for the future. And besides Facebook posts, of course, the libraries provided different kind of user services, like answering to inquiries, starting to provide walk-in service and video reference assistance. And of course, even though libraries introduced books before as well, they started to offer library lessons and library TV via internet. There were also some libraries which started to read books and news for visitors, for example, via telephone or via internet. And there were also libraries that provided really different interactive activities like web meetings as language cafes. Then there were some libraries which organized digitized material related contests. And there were some few libraries which also started Skype talking clubs for seniors, which were actually the most at-risk groups during the emergency situation. And in addition to the libraries, we also took a look at the workplace of Estonian librarians. When initially within this project, I was interested in how Estonian librarians perceive their workplace in normal situation, then now we also started to take a look at their coping within the COVID-19 outbreak and the emergency situation. And for the study, we have interviewed 10 librarians, and we have conducted semi-structured interviews with librarians of having the very different professional backgrounds. So one of the first things we monitored was the workday of Estonian librarians. Under normal circumstances, a typical workday can be described as relatively fixed in time. In terms of working hours, there are clear working hours, but in terms of emergency situation, the working hours became quite blurry. Normally, a librarian would work, with few exceptions, in the library building, but now also the work at home was encouraged very highly. And of course, it also brought some gaps, because there were some people who were working in the library, there were some people who were working at home, and then those people who were working at home, some had to, you know, take care of children and elderly, some people were just focusing on the work. And also the emergency situation brought some differences in terms of time usage, like multitasking and focusing on specific tasks, which was also something that changed quite a bit. And of course, you have probably all noticed that also the meetings were changing. When before it was possible to conduct face-to-face trainings and meetings, then everything moved to online And of course, one big change during the emergency situation was that when previously the changes could take time, the training could take time, decision making could take time, but now there was huge time pressure on decisions to making very quickly. And also there were some librarians who mentioned that there was a certain kind of fear of missing out because they had to follow what other libraries are doing. And of course, it all raises a question. If the visitors are gone, aren't we supposed to have more time now? So next thing was that we looked at the question, where does time fly to now? So we discovered that, of course, there was more time to do some things that had to be postponed before. Like I said before, conducting inventories was started, then some librarians could spend more time by repairing books or organize their email box or compile new documents. And of course, in some libraries, the librarians had to start helping out their colleagues who now did distance work by replacing them or organizing work packages for them and from them in case they had to deliver something back to the library. And then there were also some processes which became more time consuming than ever before. For example, lending a book needed now a lot of mediation. And of course, one more thing, when libraries started to provide new services, it also meant new tasks and it also meant obtaining new skills. So by the end of the day, one could ask herself a question, how big is the pressure and which of these different kind of tasks one could do, but which of these tasks one had to do. So there was a huge pressure of immediacy. And we were also asking questions about hints and tips and tools about how to cope with this kind of difficult situation or accelerating situation. We had some tips and hints from the good old times, like the normal situation. So librarians very often, in order to cope with fast-paced work, they use different tools that help to remember things like post-its and calendar notes and notifications. Then the librarians use also to-do lists. Either they make them in the evening or in the morning, or sometimes they also make to-do lists also during the process. So in this case, the post-its are very helpful as well. And there were some librarians who thought that planning more demanding activities or tasks to those times of the day is a good idea when you are less distracted and when you feel more fresh and productive. And of course, delegating is sometimes important in libraries because sometimes you might ask yourself a question, is this email really for me? Maybe I should delegate it to somebody else who knows better. And of course, when we talk about librarians who have really extensive experiences from the work, then a good idea is also to figure out what helps you to stay focused and creative throughout all those years when working in libraries. And yes, we were thinking that maybe these hints could also help us during the times of crisis. So this is something to consider. And to conclude, when we have libraries which have closed their doors over 2 months, what does it actually mean? One of the things is that there are, of course, many new avenues and new services and target groups and new skills. But by the end of the day, we have to ask which of these services will stay, which of these services will go. Then, of course, the invisible work in libraries. Is it really valued when the library is closed to the visitors? How we can explain to the people outside the library landscape that this work is also important? Then in the background, of course, during the emergency situation, we had the immediacy pressure, we had stress and anxiety in general, we had increased workload, especially for these people who have children or elderly at home, and some people also may have experienced increased economic issues, and maybe some other problems. So the question is how to proceed sustainably without getting hurt, because this is also important. So I will finish here. And in the end of this presentation, we also thank our supporters and the people who have made this presentation possible. So we thank the Estonian Research Council postdoctoral research grant PUT JD 838. Then we are also grateful to all those interviewees who are willing to share their experiences. And we also thank different people and institutions who were involved in making this video presentation, like Alar Suia from University of Tartu. And also thank Videal. And we also thank University of Tartu Library for their permission to use their building as a filming location. And if you have any questions or comments, then you can email us at these two addresses. So thank you for your attention.
So Ilmar, it's really good to know that the first wave is now over and we can go to the library once again. Yes.
Oh dear, what's going on?